When you die, that does not mean that you lose to cancer. You beat cancer by how you live, why you live, and in the manner in which you live. So live, live, fight like hell. And when you get too tired to fight, then lay down and rest and let somebody else fight for you.
And we're here fighting for Stuart Scott. This coming ESPYS is the 10th anniversary of Stuart's remarkable speech. The man said many things on television that were memorable and had staying power. But forget a catchphrase. That was a message of strength that will remain with all of us forever. We miss him, but his message and his words live on. And so does he and two young women of strength and substance, just like the parents that raised him, Taelor and Sydni Scott. Who I turn around and I look at you and I just think you were just little girls running around the office, and now I look at you and you're Ivy Leaguers and you're grown women and you're doing your thing, and I just have this giant smile on my face. It's so good to see you. I know how many aunts and uncles you have in your ESPN family, and your Uncle Scott's giving you a hug from here in D.C. I appreciate you joining us, and I would just ask you to begin. Maybe Taelor, you could go first, and then Sydni, if you would follow. Just how often is that particular speech brought up to you when people talk to you about your dad? How often is that what they ask about?
I think that oftentimes when I hear that the speech was really important to someone, it is because they have lost someone and they have helped them through a transition time in their life. And that kind of inspiration, I think that probably was his goal, was to inspire himself, to inspire others. And I think that that is the most meaningful thing, that that is what people connect to, and that it gives people some sort of feeling of being less alone in a wider sense.
Sydni, I'm curious what you've experienced.
It's something, it's been so fascinating and so driving to me over the past 10 years. I was 15, or no, I was 14 in when he gave that speech, and I'm 24 now, and it has been a constant cycle of learning and gleaning something new from those words. I remember someone in a conference told Taelor and I that when they watched that speech, they saw him saying his final goodbye. They saw him saying his final goodbye to an audience and to a public that had watched him, had grown with him, and then had fought with him. And so to be able to grow in my own life from childhood to adulthood, and to be able to seek new and to gain new insight from his words. Every time someone brings it up, I mean, of course, what Taelor said for sure, but it's fascinating, really, the different things that people get out of it and the different words that people will remember and speak to, and the you know, the choices that someone will choose to bring to us and say, these were the words that stuck to me. These were the words that I remember. And it's something really stunning to be able to have an artifact so widely known that we can continue to gain from and to learn from, and to continue to share with people.
And that fight continues, and his fight, in a sense, continues in this way. The V Foundation, a decade ago, they started the Stuart Scott Memorial Cancer Research Fund. And I wonder if you could give our viewers, and again, Taelor, I'll give you the first opportunity to sort of share it, and then Sydni, if you'd follow, just your perspective on this, just the impact that it's had, the importance that it's had. How would you frame it?
I would say that before my father was even diagnosed, the V Foundation was so important as an organization because he respected and believed so much in his father, you know, vision for a future. And so as time for him to experience something that was incredibly challenging, he had support, and he knew that that was what he wanted others to have. And the fact that the V Foundation also values equity in the healthcare space is just priceless. It's not something that you find in a ton of places. And they're obviously commitment to eradicating this disease and also treating people and helping people live full lives with it, the fact that they would commit part of their, you know, energy to raising, my father's memorial research fund has raised almost $18 million.
Wow.
Away. 10 years ago, people would not have lived as long. Mm. People live longer today. We get to see the value of those dollars. We get to see them in action. We get to see the time that people spend together.
I mean, listen, it is something, you know, it's this gradual span of time where you do not notice the changes in the mirror as you look at them every day. And then someday you look up and it's 10 years later and you're 10 years older. Taelor and I's grandfather was diagnosed with cancer shortly before he passed away earlier this year. And to me, a massive part of my dad's fund is not just the money raised. I mean, it is the $18 million raised. It's the over 50 researchers that are pursuing projects in all of these different types of cancer that affect especially different demographics of people differently. But it's also the industry, like an entire architecture of care that has formed around it, where the care that my grandfather received in his final weeks, months with this cancer diagnosis was something that was incomprehensible to my mother, to our extended family, to see him treated with care and dignity. There's an entire ecosystem of healthcare that surrounds not just the research, but the way that patients themselves are able to live with dignity. And so, yeah, you know, like it would have been so difficult to tell you day by day by day.
Sure.
What is happening? What are the differences? But to look back now on this time span and to look at the passion and the rigor of these researchers and the resources that they have available to them and the communities that surround the individuals a part of these clinical trials, it is profound and genuinely 10 years later, you know, my grandfather passed away 9 years and 10 days after our father passed away. And to be able to live in that hospital room with him, with the care, with the dignity, is just, I'm able to see my father and his legacy live on in a way that I would not have been able to tell you would be visible, would be tangible 10 years later, and it is. And so, you know, for Taelor and I, working alongside the V Foundation, working with the V Foundation and ESPN, it's special and it's profound, and it gives me a type of hope for what the future of cancer healthcare, cancer research, and the cure to cancer looks like, and that it includes my people, that it includes my community. I wouldn't have been able to tell you that so confidently 10 years ago, and today I feel it deep in my chest.
Well, my chest's pounding because I get to tell you guys something that you don't know is coming. 18 million is good. That's great. But let's do better. Between now and July 11th, when the ESPYS are held, every single dollar that is donated to the V Foundation, every single dollar will go directly to your father's fund. And there is a very generous and anonymous donor. Now don't go crying and make me cry on TV. I've been praying all day, Lord, don't let me cry on television. Every single dollar, up to $75,000, that this generous anonymous donor will match. So let's say between now and July 11th, we can get $75,000 out there among us, then that will be matched. And now we're talking, that would be $150,000, and then we could just keep going from there. So that is happening, and I get to tell you that. I'm sorry, family, to do that to you on TV. I'm not big on surprises, but I felt like this would be a decent surprise to share with you all.
I don't have any words.
That's okay.
That's incredible.
We get
it's,
to...
It's like, life-changing.
Go ahead,
it
Sydni.
It is future-preserving.
It's future preserving. Oh. It's life changing. Future preserving. Taelor and I like, I think we talk about this a lot, that it is, it's stunning, it's amazing to meet families who are, as we've said, a part of the worst, you know, one of the worst clubs in the world. But like, in recent years, Taelor and I have spoken to and talked to the researchers themselves, and the way that the money donated goes to their research, it goes to their resources, it goes to supporting them, it goes to supporting their families.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Your dad loved North Carolina. Everybody knew that. But there's nothing in the world that he loved more than his little girls. And I'm sitting here looking at the grown women you've become. And he'd be so proud, and he is so proud, and so are all of us at ESPN who love you from afar. And this was really, really cool that I got to do this. And I don't care that this is where it ends up. Taelor and Sydni, it's so good to see you guys.
Amazing to see you. Thank you so much, Scott.
Taelor and Sydni Scott with us here on SportsCenter. Please go to the graphic so I can stop crying on TV. You can support Stuart Scott's legacy by donating to the Stuart Scott Memorial Cancer Research Fund at v.org/Stuart. 100% of your donation will go to cancer research.